additional change?
Mr. Chairman, I have one that I would respectfully ask as a time-sensitive matter, as a new, I guess that would be item three on old business, and that would be for us to discuss the city-county water contracts. I will take a unanimous vote of Commissioner Evans refused, Mr. Chairman.
When you say item three, according to my old business, one, two, I have one, two, okay, and that's three, I'm waiting now. Water contract?
Yes, sir.
If there's no discussion, I just say one.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no discussion, please call the motion. That passes 4-0, Commissioner Evans refused. Thank you. Counselor, there was a talk that we might need executive session during this meeting.
That may be a byproduct of the recently added old business item.
Okay, do we need to add something about executive session for the agenda?
Though the agenda already provides for executive session if needed, and I may ask the board if you're willing to go into executive session at the end of the meeting.
Okay, thank you. Is there a motion to adopt the agenda as modified?
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no discussion, please vote on the motion. And that passes unanimously.
Please refrain from disrupting the meeting through general outbursts, applause, or comments. All comments shall be directed to the entire board and not to a particular commissioner. If you have documents with the commissioners, please provide those to the clerk. If fewer than seven copies are submitted, only one copy will be retained by the clerk as part of the permanent record. Those who wish to speak must sign up by completing a public comment or public hearing form available just outside this room. Information regarding specific requirements to address the board is listed at the podium. Please state that information prior to speaking. Per the county's broadcast policy, the county is not responsible for statements made during public meetings and does not warrant the accuracy of such statements. The public comments portion of the meeting is intended to allow speakers to make a verbal presentation to the board. The number of speakers is limited to 10. Speakers are selected on a first-come basis and will be heard in the order in which they sign up, with the exception that Forsyth County residents will be heard first, with non-county residents to follow until the allotted time has expired. Each speaker is limited to 3 minutes. The public comments portion is limited to 30 minutes. With respect to the public hearings portion of the meeting, each side, those in opposition and those in support, are allotted 10 minutes to speak. Each speaker is limited to 3 minutes. We have two public comment speakers signed up this evening. Our first speaker is Julian Bowen.
It's bad when you walk on the feet and think you've done something. There's two things I'd like to talk to you about, but before I do that, I want to congratulate Brian Tam for getting elected for the third time as District 2 Commissioner, and only one of the persons ever been elected more than that to the Board of Commissioners. And I'd like to congratulate Jim Bob for getting re-elected as the sitting chairman. Never in my memory, goes back to 1980, that a sitting chairman has been re-elected. Of course, with over 62% of the vote, that's something to be proud of. The first thing I'd like to talk to you about is the water contract. And after the situation we found ourselves in now, there's almost no way that the board and the council can come together on this. You have a signed letter of agreement, and really the best thing is for both the county and city to go before a visiting Superior Court judge and let him fill in the details of what that is. It's gonna be a situation, if you try to put all the finished water through that one water plant, that's gonna be a massive increase, and you're gonna put public safety at risk if that's done. You could have a pipe that ruptured. I imagine the pressure's gonna have to be increased because it's all gonna be coming out of one area instead of the other plant, and you could have a fire with no water pressure in the county. And then, of course, it's just aggravating for people not to have water pressure. And there's no hard feelings. And I've talked to the mayor many times over the past, 15 years, and we've worked on a lot of things together. And I understand it's tough for the county to be so big and dominant that, and you gotta also look at the situation on age. I'm 65 years old, and I'm an old man. And I can tell it every time I walk. If I was on the city council, I'd be the youngest man by 6 years. These guys have put a lot of time and effort in their public service, and they're tired, and they make mistakes. And there was a reason why Bear Bryant was forced to retire from the University of Alabama when he was 70. There's a cutoff point in which a man has to step back from the forefront of what's going on in the community. And these people are trying their best, and it's no fault of their own. So you've got to understand that a Superior Court judge, a visiting Superior Court judge, can fill in the details of the contract and do this in a situation where there's no more animosity. Now, the second thing I'd like to talk about is a local option sales tax. I came over to Forsyth County for the first time in 1968 or 1969. I can't remember what day it was. It was for a basketball game. I'd already graduated from high school. My girlfriend was a cheerleader, and I was riding the school bus. And I was amazed at how the community was. The local option sales tax is something that you need to seriously think about. Fire protection is the number one responsibility with law enforcement of an incorporated municipality. And without a fire department per se, the city of Cumming is caught up basically to where they should be.
William, can you hold on for a second? Do we wish to grant more time? Is that acceptable? About how much more time? How much more time do you think you might need?
Not very much. I'm about finished.
A minute?
A minute would be fine. I'm sorry to run over. I don't have a prepared speech. Okay. The other thing that I was mentioning is there has to be a phasing out. If a community, a city, does not have a paid fire department, and that's one of the prime reasons for having a city, and we have a county fire department that's paid for separately and administrated separately. The local option sales tax, you have to get away from the actual numbers, and you have to go back to what each project that would fund. And there's been a lot of, and what's really, really disturbing is no talking between the council and the commission. When the 77 acres was bought on Pilgrim Mill Road recently, and John Hurd didn't have a real reason to buy the property, we've been through the water plant acquisitions and things like that in Coa when I was growing up, and you don't move a water plant. That's just something that doesn't happen. So you're looking at a sewer plant on Pilgrim Mill Road, and we have so much sewer capacity that it's almost impossible to think that has to be done quickly. And I've overrun my time, and I'm sorry. Congratulations once again. It's always good to have people here elected. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Our next speaker is Hal Schneider.
Good evening, Commissioners. My name is Hal Schneider. I am a resident of Forsyth County, and I'm here speaking for myself only. As you all are well aware, the mayor has threatened to turn off the supply of raw water to the county as of October 1. That's a little more than 3 weeks from today. While I applaud the concept of bringing in a judge to fill in the details of the contract, I don't think that's going to happen in 3 weeks. And we have a crisis on our hands on the 1st of October. I would strongly urge this commission during item 3 of old business, which is added to the agenda today, to present, vote on, and approve a motion to petition the court for an injunction restraining the mayor from turning off the water on October 1. As Julian mentioned, this is and could be a serious public safety issue for the county. Secondly, I would like to reiterate a request that I've made a couple times before, that any commissioner that has a conflict because of business that they are doing with the city or their spouses doing business with the city should recuse themselves from any negotiations on the water contract. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
That was our final speaker, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Jodi. Old business taken off the agenda. 2A, yes. 2B has been postponed. And we are at item number 3, according to my agenda, which has to do with the water contract council.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, thank you very much for this. This is an item that was added by way of an amendment. I just want to go over with you very quickly where I believe that we are. With respect to the City County water contract, I believe I mentioned at the last work session, we do not have one. We don't have a raw water contract. We don't have a finished water contract. We do have an EPD permit allocation, but we don't have a straw or infrastructure in the ground to get that water independent of the City of Cumming. We now have a statement by the City of Cumming to discontinue providing the county raw water, and that statement basically manifests itself in two places. We have an August 24th, 2012 letter to the chairman from the mayor indicating that there's no reason the county should receive raw water from the intake facility, and we also have a communication from the director of the Department of Utilities of the City of Cumming indicating that direction has been given to discontinue pumping raw water to Forsyth County effective October 1st, 2002. So therefore, in spite of our best efforts, I believe we are quickly heading toward a very bona fide dispute, and one, in fact, that may necessitate court action, court involvement. And that is nothing that I'm necessarily happy about, but that is simply where we are. And the reason I bring this to you in an open session is simply because I wanted to explain why we may need to discuss this in executive session. The Open Meetings Act provides that not only may we discuss pending litigation in executive session, but we may also discuss potential litigation in executive session, so long as that potential litigation is discussed in good faith, and it truly is potential. And I believe, regrettably, that we may be to that point. I will tell you that if we discuss potential litigation in executive session, that does not mean your hands are bound to tell anyone me to sue. You have the option to discuss it with your attorney and decide that's not where you want to go right now, but my recommendation is that we do go into executive session for that purpose, and I will make that request at the end of the meeting. You may ask why am I talking about this now. The reason is because I don't have the luxury of going into executive session to talk to you about why we should go there, if you understand my point. I have to talk about that out here. I can't talk about that out there, but I'm saying it out here to say that's why I will make a recommendation that we do, and I'd seek your indulgence for that at the end of the meeting. Mr. Chairman, there's no action. I'm okay.
Would you recommend that we go into executive session now or at a later time?
Later time, Mr. Chairman, but I wanted to say it as a bona fide agenda item. I've done that. And at the end of the meeting and the executive session, when the last be called, I will ask that we go into executive session to discuss both. Well, I think actually it's potential litigation, which is specifically authorized under the Act.
And could I trouble you, please, to say again who? The first document you referred to came from?
There's two documents I was specifically referencing. One was an October 24th, 2012 letter to you from the mayor of the city.
August, not May.
Did I say September?
October.
August, forgive me, Chairman. Commissioner Tam, August.
Thank you, Counselor. Then I believe at this point we're on to administrative hearings. And that will be administrative hearing number one. Tom?
Yes, sir. Members of the board, administrative hearing 1AI, Casimar Inc. doing business at City of Cumming Square. This is located in Commission District Number 3. And this is our first administrative hearing of the night. hearings in reference to violations of the alcohol ordinance as an RV doing business at Sitco at Cumming Square at 1410 Lynn Highway. The main licensee is the Avenue Draft Order. This hearing is for the main licensee, and in this case, a citation was issued for to the employee for underage sales, as well as a citation for a note of sales ID. The letter, the certified mailing was signed and returned to our office. Thank you.
Thank you. Council. Councilor,
sir,
would you please just kind of walk people through that this would apply only to the people involved?
Absolutely. Mr. Chairman, I will. This next segment of the meeting is administrative hearings related to the Forsyth County Alcohol Code. These are administrative license hearings. These are not true public hearings in that any individual or member of the public can simply come up. These hearings are limited to only the actual licensee who wants to come up and explain mitigation, or an employee that may be subject to a sanction, or law enforcement that may want to come up and talk about the facts giving rise to the violation. So when open, the administrative hearing is commenced. The chairman will ask, after the case is made, the chairman will ask for the interested license holder or employee to approach the speaking podium, and at that point we would request that you stand up, present yourself, and come on up and ask any questions that the Board of Commissioners may ask you, or otherwise state your case or situation. Mr. Chairman.
Thank you. We've heard from Tom on 1A. Is there a motion to open the administrative hearing?
So moved. Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no discussion, please vote. That passes unanimously, and we are opening the administrative hearing for Gayatri Rathore. Are you here? Are there any other pieces of business to come forward?
Chairman, I have no other business. I do request an executive session. It is for the purpose of discussing potential litigation. Given that I only have one topic that I will be discussing with you, Commissioner Amos, I would respectfully request you continue your recusal on that item, because it will be discussed the City County Water matter under potential litigation.
Yes, sir.
Is there a motion to recess this regular meeting in order to begin executive session? We have a motion. Do we have a second? Second. We have a motion. A second. If there's no discussion, please vote. And that passes unanimously. We are recessed at 7:54 p.m. to go into executive session.
Mr. Chairman, I will want to say that I do not anticipate us coming out and taking any official action other than to close the meeting.